this is what I got as far as breakfast stuff. I'm gonna make pre-made breakfast sandwiches, put them in the freezer, and then when I'm ready, microwave it. I got turkey sausage lean, I got cage-free eggs, 2% milk cheese, whole grain English muffins, and then I also bought protein shakes for the days that I don't eat breakfast, but I need to. And typically you're supposed to try to eat within an hour of waking up and try to get some protein in. So this is the breakfast stuff that I got, and I also got some cereal. So I got Kashi Goling cereal. I'm gonna try the vanilla graham clusters. Apparently it has a lot of protein. You can see I got a lot of protein stuff. I got Special K protein, and I wanted the Special K with strawberries in it, but I need protein, so I got this one. And I'm just gonna add some raisins to it. And then also, as you can see, I drink Silk almond milk, preferably the vanilla kind, but this one's good also. I got these TV dinners, and they're really good as far as protein and fiber. I haven't tried them yet, but I just needed something for when I don't, you know, have time to prep a meal, but also that's really healthy, that's like not a Hot Pocket. They're pretty good on sugar. I know that the chicken fettuccine one is very low on sugar. It only has 2 grams. And like I said, I want to try to stick with like single sugar, single grams, single digits when it comes to sugar. Also, they don't have any trans fats. Make sure you read the labels and make sure it doesn't say like partially or any hydrogenated oil, shortening, things of that nature. And they had a lot of different types, but I tend to stick towards pasta because I like pasta. So hopefully these are good. And if they don't have too much flavor, because TV dinners tend to not have flavor, I can add some of this. I'm excited to try it. It's a Mrs. Dash garlic and herb seasoning blend. I bought this in place of salt because I want to cut out salt, so I'm going to be using this a lot. One of the meals I'm making this week is going to be tacos and rice and beans. Got this kind of rice. As you can see, it's got a decent amount of protein. The sugar is in the single digits. And it's got some sodium in it, but win some, you lose some. 200 calories. Got my taco seasoning. I've got some refried beans, which has a good amount of protein in it. Yeah, it's got a decent amount of protein. Not that much sugar. It's got some sodium in it. And 170 calories. For my tacos, I use ground turkey instead of ground beef. And I got lean. And also got this high fiber tortilla with whole grains in it. No cholesterol, no trans fats, high in fiber. It's got a really good amount of protein, and it's got omega-3, which is something that we need. So really excited about this, and it's low carb. I have Chobani plain Greek yogurt. And it's non-fat. I use this in place of sour cream. Tastes the same to me, and it's healthy. It's high in protein. And I have 2% milk cheese. And this is also high in protein. I don't want to overdo it on protein, but I want to make sure that I'm getting my protein in. As far as veggies, I got Green Giant steamers, broccoli, and cheese. I think, if I'm correct, it's low calorie. It's very low in sugar. You guys can't see that, but no trans fats. And has 2 grams of protein. Not a lot, but I'm not stunting that, because you can get your protein from elsewhere, like chicken, pork, things of that nature. Also, I bought plain because sometimes you just want plain, but I may put like a light ranch dressing on it. And I bought a couple of peppers. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with the green pepper yet. I might use that on the side with some kind of dish. Chicken, maybe. I don't know. But I got the red pepper because I love snacking on red peppers. For a salad, I like, personally, spinach with blueberries. And then you can add the Mrs. Dash garlic and herb for enhanced flavor. And then I also personally like Italian salad dressing. It's best to get light, but, you know, we'll just have to cheat with that. And then I also got turkey bacon bits. I'm excited to try this. And I might add some boiled eggs, maybe. But I'm definitely going to add cheese. I'm going to add my 2% milk cheddar cheese. For snacks, I have apples, my favorite kind, Fuji. And I got some peanut butter. Doesn't matter what brand, as long as it says natural, because it doesn't have a bunch of excess ingredients in it that you don't know how to pronounce. And it doesn't have any trans fats. This is specifically roasted peanuts, salt, sugar, and palm oil. I bought some cheese to go along with my fruit. Apparently, if you eat cheese along with any fruit, it helps you absorb all the nutrients out of it better. And I love cheese, so I might just eat the cheese by itself. This I've never had before, but I found a coupon for it, and it must be good. It's granola mix, gluten-free, it's high in protein. The sugar is a little high, but it's not too bad. And I'll probably mix that in with my Chobani yogurt, which is a good source of protein. I got the Greek yogurt and blueberry, key lime, and mango flavor. Again, it's a good source of protein. It's low in sugar, so I'm excited about all my little snacks. Okay, these are no rhyme or reason. some protein bars for post-workout, or, you know, those days where I don't eat breakfast like I'm supposed to and I don't have a protein drink nearby. I bought this for chicken, baked chicken, of course, and I'm just gonna season the chicken with that. And that'll be a nice little lovely experiment. I got Smart Balance butter because apparently I can use butter on vegetables because it helps you absorb the nutrients better that's in your vegetables, but it depends on what kind of butter. So like the ingredients in this: butter, cream, salt, canola oil, water, EVA, fish oil. That's it. No trans fats. Nothing I can't pronounce. So, I'm excited. Hope this tastes pretty good. I'm probably going to use this on my broccoli. Not the cheese broccoli, but the plain. I got some EVOO for cooking. You know, like cooking something in a skillet. Or baking in the oven, but not frying. Do not use EVOO to fry. It will be a disaster. And this is really not healthy. It's just more so my cheat. Never tried it before, so I'm gonna try it. So for post-workout, I bought Powerade Zero so that I can replenish my electrolytes. And it has zero calories. And I bought some Crystal Light, you know, which you add to the water bottles. Because I need to stop drinking this, which is so good, but it's so sugary. Oh my goodness. So, you better do your job and you better taste good, Crystal Light.